get out of the ring for my first 100, 200 fights, I'd find someone that, you know, a senior official, and I'd say, how did I do? And I would sit there, and someone would tell me how I did, you know, because you're hyped up, you really don't know. When you get to about 200 fights, pro, I don't know.
Jack Reese, Russell Moore, what's going on here today, guys?
So, Russell, myself, Tom Taylor, we put together a program to help referees up their level of skills. And we took the years of experience and all our fights and all the mistakes that we've made and all the discussions that we had over the years, and we formalized it into a three-day training program for referees. And today we have 55 people from referees from all over the world, Germany, Poland, Canada, and quite a bit from the United States, and we're going to give them this three-day course.
You guys are the best of the best. You have the most experience. Tell me if I'm wrong. You do a good job if both sides hate you.
That's true. You got a red corner and a blue corner. So if they were, if the red corner won, the blue corner is not happy. It's vice versa. But with this class, what we're doing is that we're actually sharing all of our experiences, because you certainly cannot succeed until you learn from your mistakes and or the mistakes of others. We didn't have this when we were starting off. We didn't have these kind of classes that
guidelines
really,
and
they really diagnosed the art of refereeing. As Jack and Tom and I are trying to share with the class.
If someone wants to come participate in the future, how do they get a hold of you guys?
Pretty easy. Just look us up on soularbiter.com, soularbiter.com.
And there you have it. You could learn, and it could help you understand. It could help you become a better referee, a better judge, and all that.
Thanks,
what's the one thing you take from this experience, from your perspective?
Well, we teach a lot of philosophy, and we try to teach the students to take a much broader approach to just two guys fighting in a ring or two gals fighting in a ring. There's a lot more to consider now that there's social media, and we have to consider the stakeholders in the sport of boxing, which are the fans, the fighters, the promoters, the writers,
the commentators. Networks.
Yeah, we have to educate them to why we're doing what we're doing. We can't just do things arbitrarily. We can't just stop a fight without setting up the stoppage. We can't just take points without exposing and expressing that this guy is pushing us to our limit because he's fouling that opponent. And guys who don't get that get themselves in trouble.
Can I put you guys on the spot, last thing? Daniel Dubois, Usyk, low blow, no low blow. Are they actually discussing it inside right now?
We're going to be discussing that in depth, but let me just put it this way. Look, Russ and I will not comment on what that is. We're not allowed to, but it's unprofessional. What I can tell you is I could define for you and the fans what a low blow is. The word beltline, waistline, waistband, it's all gotten convoluted. And it's because the trunks have grown over the years. Back in the day, you had fighters wearing short trunks with a 1-inch elastic band, and that elastic band said, look, see where my belt sits? That's the hip line, that's the line, that's the low blow. When a guy's got his trunks up to here and his belly button's covered, it's not the top of the waistband. So to make it clear for the fans, a punch on the waistline is fair. If it's on the hip line, if it's below, it's not. If it's between my belly button's here, this is all fair in here.
Keep in mind the fighter has a foul-proof cut. Foul-proof means foul-proof. Tomorrow, when we go over the low blows, we're actually going to demonstrate a low blow, and I'd be willing to wear the cup so we can show that, yes, in fact, underneath the cup, yes, you're going to get hurt. Sideways, sometimes you're going to get hurt as well. But a punch on the cup, the cup should do its job, and that's foul-proof.
And I've got a small bat, and I'm literally going to hit him with the bat tomorrow.
You guys are about to go viral, so there you have it. Where do people follow you on social media?
Soul Arbiter.
Soul Arbiter.
Soul okay, Arbiter. Make sure to follow them, stay tuned, and come get some knowledge once a year, right?
Whenever we get to it, yeah.
Okay, stay tuned. Elisek back reporting.
I'm Elisek back. Elisek back reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elisek back reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elisek back reporting.